everyone. Welcome to the Knives Save Lives channel. I am here today to do a two-month review of the Shirogorov 95 clone. First, I thought I'd show you some knives that I'm doing for a restaurant here in town. They wanted me to sharpen these up. I've got a friend that works there. Gives me a little bit of extra cash in my pocket every once in a while. Got some big monstrous knives here. But, yep, I've got all of them down, all the way down to here. But I need to do these last three still. These were quite a beast to get sharp. I started them out at 500 grit, worked up to 1,000, then to 2,000, then to 6,000, then to 8,000. So they should be pretty happy with these knives. Should be nice and sharp. So anyway, without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and get on to the review of the Shirogorov 95 clone. Here is the knife. The Shirogorov 95 clone. 9CR 18 MOV steel blade. From what I understand, it's an equivalent to 440C. Full flat ground, drop point, flipper design, full titanium scales, titanium pocket clip with a single screw mount. The steel insert on top of the lock bar. The underneath this pocket clip, there is a detent ball that's mounted into the handle scale, and it goes up into a indentation in the bottom of this pocket clip's base, and that keeps it from being able to swivel back and forth on the single screw without it being seated, without the pocket clip being seated into the handle. Pretty excellent design, a lot of attention to detail. Even the machining on the inside of this knife looks excellent. It's picture perfect. The handle scales are really nice. They have rounded these corners in all the areas that matter here. On the outside, it's pretty nice ergonomics. I can give it a good hard squeeze. Don't really have any problems, except for this cutout here is just a tad sharp, and I can feel it, but it doesn't hurt me. So, if you have soft hands, maybe it would bother you, I don't know. It has jimping on the flipper. This actually has a pretty heavy detent. This thing, when I first got it, I thought it was an assisted opener, and it is not. I think this knife is just overall a real winner for design. I'd actually really like to get a hold of a real one, although I'd need to save some coin up for that. Don't really have 1,200 bucks just lying around to blow on a knife right now, but maybe one day. I certainly would buy one if I had the money to spare. The blade is perfectly centered. It may not appear that way for the camera. Cameras never really seem to show that very well. But I assure you, it is perfectly centered. The blade has given me no up or down or side to side play in all this time. I have not had to adjust any of the screws on this. I even removed the pocket clip to sand down this tip of this pocket clip here because it was sharp. And I put it back on. I never even used any Loctite. It still never worked loose in over 2 months of carry. It's just been a really excellent knife so far. I certainly would have to give this knife two thumbs up. The only thing that I think that could improve on this is, instead of putting their maker's mark on there, maybe, I mean, since since they can make these knives and sell them, make a profit off of it, on $63 shipped to my door, that they could save a little bit of money and not rip off somebody's design by putting their logo there. They certainly could just manufacture their own style of knives. This knife, it does have some moral dilemmas that you could take into account when thinking about a purchase of one of these because of that. However, this knife wasn't presented to me or represented to me to be the real thing, and that I was getting the real thing for a discount. I know I was buying a clone and not the real thing. I wasn't duped into it. You know, somebody didn't try to sell me this for $800 or $900 and say it was discount or whatever. It was $63 from the wholesaler or whatever it was, and to me, you know, so I know it's not real. It's a real knife. It's not a real Shirogorov, though. But mainly, when I got this, my wife gave me some extra cash. She wanted me to spend it on myself, buy myself something that I'd like. I searched through literally hundreds of pages of knives looking for something that fit just a few criteria. One, I wanted titanium handles, if I could. Aluminum probably would have done just fine. Preferably metal handles, pocket clip, full flat ground blade, and decent ergonomics. Those things, and locking, obviously, like a frame lock or a back lock or something. It's actually really surprising how few knives of this type of design are out there. That's basically why I settled on this one. It's got everything I wanted. It's got rounded handles, which almost no one does. It has broken edges on the inside. They took care of that. It has a steel insert on the lock bar. It's almost a perfect knife. The one thing about this knife, or two things actually, I'll say. Sorry, three. I always think of more. Sorry about that. But anyway, the sharpness of this cutout here for the lock arm, the sharpness of this pocket clip, and what was the third thing? I can't think of the third thing now. Anyway, those two things were the worst two things about this. Oh, yes. This lock bar right here, where this is beveled off, if it had just the slightest bit of texturing to it, it would make this excellent. Just totally perfect to me. I mean, there are other things, like you can reach the tip with your fingernail. You can also reach in here and get a hold of this edge there, down at the base of the blade. Those things I haven't had a problem with, although you might want to be careful. You could get this, your finger caught in here, or your shirt, or your pants, or something like that. But mainly, this is just an excellent functional knife. It's everything I wanted. The full flat ground blade, the drop point's nice. I even used this knife in comparison to the Chris Reeve Unumzon over the last couple of months. And it actually holds an edge better than the Unumzon. And, well, at least for cardboard cutting. So, depends the level for cutting performance changes when the media you're cutting changes. If you're cutting gravel with both knives, or either one of them is going to, or roof shingle, like tar shingles, with the abrasives on the top. You're cutting that with, you know, either one of these knives, are both going to go dull extremely fast. But this actually held a nicer edge longer. It had better ergonomics and felt better in the hand. And just overall functioned better. I like that it has the flipper. Flipper is nice. If you're wearing gloves, it doesn't matter how big or thick or thin the gloves are, you can get that blade to come out. One out of 20 people that I've let handle this knife has actually been able to open it with one hand. So, I mean, I realize that they are kind of against having people flicking their knives open because it can cause peening on the stopping surfaces and could cause like lock rock or something like that. But just overall in general, this is a much nicer knife. I would like to get, like I said, the actual genuine Shirogorov. I'd love to have one. That'd be pretty nice to have. One of these days I will probably get one, if I can afford it. So, but anyway, it's just been a pretty excellent knife so far. I've used it for cutting up wood and making like little wedges out of sticks. I used it to do food prep. I've done a lot of cardboard cutting with it. I've done slight little bit of prying with it. I've dug up weeds with it. It's really done pretty well. So, overall, I'd have to say I give it 2 thumbs up. But this is a knife that I would not recommend for anyone to buy, because it is a slight against the company that they have counterfeited off of. Other than that, I'd say, you know, it's a totally excellent design. Anyway, I hope my review hasn't upset too many people. I realize that it probably seems kind of shady of me to purchase one of these, but like I said, I just had everything I was looking for, and it was in the price range that I could afford at the time, so that's what I bought. Thanks for watching. Leave me some comments.